Hi guys, welcome to Neat Video Tutorials, and today's topic is Jitter of Details. If you want to follow along, I've included a link to the original video that you can download and do everything I do. If you like this video, make sure you hit the subscribe button. We'll be back with more cool stuff about noise reduction. Now let me show you what I mean by Jitter of Details. This is a short night clip with some noise and flicker, but if I zoom in and show you this bit, you can see that this line, this edge, and this chimney are just terrible. They're kind of jumping up and down, left and right. You may even think that there is some hot air between the camera and these objects. In fact, there's no hot air here. This effect is something that we call jitter of detail, or jitter for short. Jitter is usually caused by inaccurate noise reduction and compression applied in the camera. Typically, we see this problem in videos taken in very low light by smaller devices like action cameras, drones, phones, and also older DSLR cameras. The good news is, Neat Video now can deal with jitter of details. But first things first, in order to kill this jitter, you need to remove the noise from the video. And as this video has already been spoiled by the camera's built-in noise reduction, the original noise has been ruined, and we need to use generic profile. Click this button. This has instantly brought us to profile check, where we need to adjust generic profile. By that, I mean setting the generic noise slider to a value that will allow us to remove as much noise as possible without turning all the details into mesh. And right now, I can't see any noise in this frame. This can either mean that I'm very lucky and got the correct generic noise setting right away, or the slider is actually set too high. So, I want to bring the slider a bit to the left to find out the spot when the noise starts coming back in. Aha! This is it! I will take one step back so no noise is visible here. Let's quickly check the rest of the frame. Everything looks good, so I'm leaving the generic noise at this level. Now, let's switch to the Adjust and Preview tab. Here, go through the steps of Filter Settings Check, do Noise Level Check, Local Flicker Check, and repeated frame check. Now, when the noise and flicker issues are addressed, let's have a look at this area again. Zoom in and click play. It's still terrible and wobbly. Let's see what Neat Video's Jitter of Details tool can do. First, I'll create another variant to be able to compare things with Jitter of Details on and off later. Variants plus perfect. And now, I'll start moving the slider to the right, checking how it's affecting the picture. Still jittering. So, I brought the threshold to +300%, but the jitter is still here. This is kind of expected given the severity of the original movement. Now, I'll enable extended filtration by checking this box. And look, this has done the trick. I just need to bring the threshold down a bit and stop just before the jitter reappears. If you leave this value too high, you may lose some details. And that's actually all. Time to check the difference in the results with the jitter of details on and off. This is the first variant where I didn't use jitter of details tool. And this is the second variant with the adjusted jitter of details. So what do you think? I would say the difference is huge and the results on the right is awesome. That's all, guys. We hope you find this tutorial helpful. If so, make sure you subscribe to our channel and give us a thumbs up. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments. We'll be happy to help. And bye for now.